Why do we need complex numbers? All we need to calculate is real, right? In the end, yes, we will get real quantities. However, complex numbers can simplify our computations in the meantime tremendously. And that is why these numbers are used so often in physics and engineering. Model a problem, forget about real reality for a moment, and use complex numbers to do all kinds of computations, finish your computations, and come back to reality using the results of your computations. So, what are these magical complex numbers? That is what you will learn in this video. We will introduce them using quadratic equations. If you look at the equation x squared minus 1 equals 0, you have two solutions, x equals minus 1 equals plus 1. If you look at the equation x squared minus 2x plus 1 equals 0, we can factorize that as x minus 1 squared equals 0, so we see x equals 1 is a solution of that equation. However, we see that it is a so-called double zero. It occurs twice in the factorization, so solutions are x equals 1 and x equals 1. And in such a case, mathematicians count the 1 double. So we say this equation also has two solutions, x equals 1 and x equals 1. So the second quadratic equation also has two solutions. And then we look at the third, x squared plus 1 equals 0. And then we see, hey, x squared is always positive, because any square of a real number is positive. We add 1, so we get something strictly positive, so that will be never 0. So that equation has no solutions. Well, that's too bad. So some quadratic equations have two solutions, and this one has no solutions. Can we resolve that in some way? Well, obviously not if we just use real numbers. So let us introduce a new number. We introduce a new number I, the imaginary unit. And that's a number such that I squared equals minus 1. So you immediately see that that is a new number, because the square of any real number will be just positive. So we have one new number, I. And using this one number, we can form a whole set, a whole bunch of new numbers. We form numbers of the form a plus b times I, where a and b are both real. And we will call the set, which contains all those new numbers, the set of complex numbers designated by the letter C. Let's look at a few examples. We can choose a and b in any way we like. We'll call this a the first part, we'll call that the real part of set. And the b, we will call that the imaginary part of set. And we can choose any a we like. For example, if we choose a equals 3 and b equals 5, we get the complex number 3 plus 5 times I. Of course, we can choose any a and b we like, so we can set a to 0. So we set the real part to 0. What do we get then? If we take, for example, b equals minus 1, we get the complex number 0 plus minus 1 times I minus I. And such a special complex number, which has a real part 0, is called purely imaginary. We can also put, of course, the b equal to 0. B is a real number, so it can be any number. We can also set it to 0 and set, for example, a to square root of 2, then we get the set 3 over here equals square root of 2. That's 0 times I. Hey, but that is just a real number. And in that case, well, we call the complex number real. Not purely real, but just real. And then you see, hey, apparently the real numbers are a subset of the complex numbers. Indeed, and we can draw that using Venn diagrams. Well, when we started a long time ago with numbers, you started counting like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. We add the number 0 and you get a set of natural numbers. Then you start subtracting numbers, you get 4 minus 3 equals 1 is fine, but when you try 3 minus 4, that doesn't work. So you added the negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and you get the set z. Then you started dividing, like 4 over 2 equals 2, 6 over 3 equals 2, that's all fine. But when you try 3 over 6, that doesn't work out. So you add numbers, you add the quotients, q. And I think at this moment we are about at high school, when you are solving quadratic equations, x squared equals 4 gives plus or minus 2, that is fine. But when you try to solve x squared equals 2, you cannot write that as a quotient anymore, and you need to introduce numbers like square root of 2 and pi, etc. And you get a set of all real numbers. And now, finally, we are at the last set, which is around that one. It's a set of complex numbers, and we are done with all sets of numbers which surrounds all the other sets we've seen up till now. So now you know what the complex numbers are, how they are defined, and what are an imaginary parts of a complex number are.